We came to the conclusion that there are actually 5 challenges in the cooperative sector in Vietnam. And based on those 5 challenges, we have been invited to develop an action plan, and we signed a memorandum of understanding with the National Cooperative Alliance. It's called the VCA, the Vietnamese Cooperative Alliance. And in this contract, in this agreement, we identified to tackle the 5 topics, the challenges in the sector, which is stimulating trust, because there's a lot of mistrust by members in cooperatives. The second topic is market linkage, because cooperatives don't have a clear market linkage yet. Third is access to finance. The fourth topic that we are addressing is to improve business management and business planning. And the final one is to include more technology in the sector, because the sector also needs to make use of the modern technology to also increase their efficiency to become more competitive with other sectors. It has resulted in the cooperative development plan. So at the end, the cooperative development plan that Agriterra designed has the ambition to have an integral and holistic approach where we have piloting in several regions with all the actors on board. So the policymakers, the private sector, the public sector, and the financiers. The cooperative development plan is something that can be replicated for other countries as well.
Chúng tôi qua Hà Lan và cũng trao đổi và học tập kinh nghiệm liên quan đến lĩnh vực hợp tác xã nông nghiệp đó. Bởi vì đối với đất nước chúng tôi thì ở nông thôn thì vấn đề hợp tác xã nông nghiệp là một chủ đề chính trong cái phát triển kinh tế nông thôn.
I have a chance to discuss with many people from the bank, from the cooperative and the other division in Netherlands. We study a lot from them.
Het feit dat ze nu hier zijn is echt om te ontdekken hoe kunnen we ze toerusten, welke kennis en ervaring kunnen ze allemaal meenemen.
Tôi cũng thấy có nhiều cái vấn đề mà giữa Bộ Nông nghiệp và Agriculture có thể phối hợp trao đổi và hỗ trợ trong cái thời gian tới.
Ja, ontzettend herkenbaar hoe ze daar ook vechten en knokken om zo'n positie in de keten te hebben. Dat valt natuurlijk niet mee, want je wil je product graag tegen zo'n goed mogelijke prijs verkopen. Maar voordat je het weet, dan zijn er andere kapers op de kust en die interesseren boeren om vooral aan hun te verkopen. Ja, dan verdwijnt het geld heel vaak in de keten en komt het niet ten goede aan de primaire bedrijven.
The thing is, it needs to be organized in a holistic way. In other words, you need to get the attention from all the players in the sector, because you cannot do it alone. So if you have the willingness and the capacity to include all the different actors, then definitely this is an approach that can work in, I would say, every country that wants to transform and modernize the cooperative sector.